In the previous lesson, I have discussed the fecal culture. In this lesson, I'm going to discuss isolation of larvae using the Baermann test or techniques. The main objectives of the Baermann test is to isolate the larvae of nematodes from fecal samples, such as from feces or fecal culture or soil or tissue for diagnostic and research purpose. The sample used for isolation of larvae must be free of contamination. Therefore, feces directly collected from rectum in case of ruminants or immediately collected freshly voided feces from dog and cats are highly recommended for the diagnosis of longworm larvae. Interestingly, if the eggs of hookworms, ascarids, strongylids are present in feces, they may hatch quickly to the larval form and can be confused with the larvae of longworms or strongyloids. Further, if the sample is contaminated with the free living larvae from soil and plants, the identification of the larva will be more challenging and time consuming. The equipment required for performing this test is to hold the fecal sample in water so that the larvae can migrate out and be collected. Instead of the true Baermann apparatus, scientists or technicians are using alternative to it, following the same principle. So instead of funnel, a plastic or disposable wine glass with hollow stem or something similar can be used. A short piece of tubing with a clamp is attached to the end of the funnel. The funnel should be clamped to a metal stand. For conducting this test, take 10 grams of fecal samples or more in a piece of double-layered cheesecloth or gauze. Gather the cheesecloth or gauze around the fecal sample to make a pouch. The fecal pouch then hang in the funnel with the help of a stick. If you don't have funnel, you may use wine glasses with hollow stem, and alternatively you can put the sample in a suspended piece of wire mesh or sieve. The funnel is then filled with lukewarm water or physiological saline. Ensure that the fecal pouch is fully immersed in the fluid. Allow the sample to sit for at least 8 hours or overnight. Collect the fluid from the funnel and centrifuge to collect the sediments. You can add 1 to 2 drops of Lugol iodine and examine it under a microscope. Follow this table for identification and interpretation of the larvae. Keep in mind that overall identification of larvae of different nematodes are challenging and require an expert and experienced parasitologist. If samples are contaminated by the free living larvae from soil and plants, the identification would be even more difficult and time consuming. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any question, write it in the comment section below. I'll be happy to answer.